my name is Blake Bashoon. In part one of our how-to videos, we showed you how to fire this locomotive up. Today, we're going to show you how to run it, from how to start off at the station, to how to stop, and even how to shut it down at the end of the day. So come on along and take a ride on the 574 to show you how to run a steam locomotive. We're going to go through the basic controls of the engine. Probably the most obvious for most people is the throttle. You pull this back and the engine will move. The control direction, you have the Johnson bar over here in the corner. Forward, and the engine goes forward. Put it in the back section and it goes in reverse, and of course in the center it's in neutral and the engine won't move. Over here you have the brake valve, the big yellow lever. In this engine, all you got to do is pull it down and the brakes apply. Put it back up, the brakes release. The brakes on this engine are steam operated. You also have your water glass right here above the brake handle. That tells you how much water is currently in the boiler. We're running a little high on water right now. Right below here is the firebox. You can see there's a little coal still burning in there. You need a little coal here in a little bit, and we'll show you how to do that. But that's where you put your coal in. And finally, probably one of the most favorite of most people is the whistle. It's this yellow handle right over here. You pull it back, and it blows the whistle. Also, you have a blower valve right here. This controls the draft on the engine when the engine is sitting. Just a small steam line up to the steam nozzle from the exhaust and the cylinders, and it shoots up the stack. For more on the blower, look at the part one video. And those are the basic controls of the engine in the cab. One last thing before you get going, we're going to go to the primary way to get water in the engine. Water is probably the most important thing you need to keep in the steam engine to keep from boiler damage. On this engine, it's the injector. I have a knob here on the tender that opens up the water line. You can see when I open the knob, water begins to come out the overflow down here. And what I do is I have a steam valve up in the cab, I turn that on, and send steam down the injector. I back off the water so there's no water coming out the overflow. And it's now putting water into the boiler. To turn it off, I do the reverse process. I turn the steam off first, then I turn off the water. If you turn the steam on first or turn the steam off last, what you'll do is you'll actually overheat your injector. And that way, next time you want to use it, it may not pick up until you cool it off by running water through, and that's wasting a lot of water. So you always want to make sure that when you turn it on, the steam goes on last, and when you turn it off, the steam goes off first. Just as important to keep water in the boiler is to make sure you have enough water in the tender. Be sure to stop every now and then and fill up the tender. You don't want to run out in the middle of the railroad. Now we got water in there, we got to make sure the fire keeps going. Otherwise, there'll be nothing to boil the water. This engine runs on coal. So what you have to do every now and then, depending on the engine, depending on how often you have to shovel, this engine's every few minutes. You gotta put a couple shovelfuls of coal into the firebox. As I said in part one when we were firing up, it's important to get all areas of the firebox, all the way in the front, all the way in the back, and make sure to get your corners. I then take my poker and go nice, make sure the fire is level. You really don't want the fire to go above the door. Because then what you're doing on most engines is you're covering up the bottom set of flues. And that's going to severely reduce your draft and your heat transfer. You're not going to make steam as well. So now we'll shut the door and it'll start to catch. If you're not shoveling, you want to keep that door closed as much as possible. Otherwise, you're putting in unneeded cold air, and that can start the rear set of flues and the back flue sheet will actually start to expand and contract unnecessarily, and you can start getting leaks in the back. All right, we got plenty of water, plenty of steam, and freshly stocked coal. So now we're ready to depart. I'll put the Johnson bar in a full forward position. Two toots on the whistles, people know we're going forward. And we're ready to pull back on the throttle. Easy does it, you don't want to spin the drivers. Away you go.
hill here. Back off the throttle a little bit when we get towards the top of the hill. We're kind of coasting.
Crossing.
Not much. I'll turn off the injector now. About a half a glass is where I like to keep it. Little help. Traffic's out of the way, so we're moving slowly again, just kind of coasting along, watching out for switches. When it's cold out like it is now, you can't always rely on the springs underneath the sprung switches. You got to make sure the points are all the way over. Excess wear from quickly jolting them into full speed. Watching out for traffic ahead. We're gonna have a meet here, so let's stop here in the siding. Again, easy on the brakes for a nice smooth stop.
Are we?
Well, today we showed you the basic controls of how to run the engine, and we also did a trip around the railroad. I hope this has been informative in how to show you how to properly run locomotive. Many of you guys have engines that you just recently acquired and are still learning how to run. We're always informed for you guys who are still trying to shop and find a locomotive or beginning to build a locomotive. If you have any questions, be sure to leave it in the comments page just like in part one. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to the Steam channel. My name is Blake Michoud, and I'll see you in our next how-to video.